Coach, thank you. EA Sports coverage of the National Football League brings us to Gillette Stadium in Foxborough, Mass. All the success in New England over the last few decades, and this crowd has never been more enthusiastic. A moment ago, the Pats emerged from their locker room. They are set as they square off with the Kansas City Chiefs. Defending champs 42-27 behind four Alex Smith touchdown. Here's second and 10 now from the 29.
By 20!
Looking back to the end, second down is throwing another but it's incomplete. He was looking for Julian Edelman that time, and it's third down. Well, not to get too overcritical there because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right. That pass will go from incomplete to complete.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Working from the gun, it's Brady. It's taken down. Chiefs set.
They just snuffed out every route that was going. Quarterback got rid of the football.
On fourth down now is the lefty Ryan Allen to punt. Back deep is Tyreek Hill. This is taken at the 18. What a 59 yards. Tough to do better than that. And it's Chiefs football, first and 10. And now here comes Kansas City. Will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their own 24. Stick.
Always. That is the threshold. You want to keep him under that if you want to play good defense.
On second down.
Ready!
Now the Holmes. On target out of the middle of Hill. And he's able to get out to the 32. Brought down there. They stop him throwing three that time, and that'll bring up fourth down.
Look at this. So tackle has become almost a lost art in the NFL game. But it's so important to tackle well on these receivers, especially in a play like this one. Third down. The game underneath stuff. You got to go and make the tackle right away.
Edelman set to return. A beautiful throw. The ball had a 49-yard pop and a net of just 39 following the 10-yard return. And the Patriots take over. So the Patriots coming out now. And our game's hit a little bit of a lull here, a little bit of a snag. Punts on back-to-back drives.
And old-school coaches don't necessarily mind that. Didn't turn it over, right? Didn't create a big play for the other team. Right now, what you're looking for is can you gain an advantage in field position? And that's what both teams are seeking right now.
Yeah, they'll be seeking to gain that advantage here on this drive. A gain of three, second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one will swallow.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't want
this. This big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Here's second and 7 now from the 28.
Set, 20,
yeah! And second down, Michelle. And he'll his way up across the 30 to the 32.
Good job.
3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about four to go.
So many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blow. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
20! Not 80! Not 80!
From the gun after the gun. A second and two after that last catch, good for 8 yards.
By 20! By 80!
They fake the handoff. Now Brady. A second and long following the holding penalty.
By 20!
To the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that, got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
So first and second down went the wrong direction. They'll try to be better here on third and 13. Gives him a first and 10 up at the 44. What makes a good run blitz a good run blitz?
The ability to stay on task, to follow up your assignment, go to the gap you're supposed to cover, and not be deterred by anything else.
Hey,
we got
three down.
By 20! By 20! Now flags come in. Look like one of the Patriots made a move. Second down and long.
20! By 20!
Shotgun now for Brady. That's going to be incomplete. Ron Parker there in on the coverage, and he knocked it away.
The goal of anyone running a curl route is to make sure you try and get defenders on your back and shield them away from the football. But sometimes, even when you run a good route, the defense finds a way to knock it away.
New England on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and 14.
20! By 20!
In possession to begin quarter number two, but likely not for long as they're in punt formation to kick it away. Here's Ryan Allen now as he'll punt it away for the second time. And out come the Chiefs now.
They're going to have to go at least 50, 60 yards here if they want to ensure that they don't have to punt the ball like they did last time.
Yeah, so what you're saying is we're not playing to just get out of the shadow of your own goal line, right? You're playing to make sure the punter doesn't see the field again, so it's not picking up a couple of first downs. You want to pick up 5 or 6 first downs and make sure you move the ball into their territory.
Here we go! Blue 45! Blue 45!
Well, starting to punt on the ground. Doomed right from the start.
They just about ran into every defender on that one, didn't he? It felt like everyone got a piece of that tackle.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11.
Ready! 3-39! 3-39!
Mahomes to throw and something in. The tight end Kelsey has it.
Try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
Ready! Blue 45! Blue 45!
Throwing is Mahomes on third. He completes it to Hunt. And able to get it across the 20 before they get to it. That goes for a Chiefs first down, 14 yards. And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going to have to be aware of him. Where is he lining up? What can he do? What kind of damage can he do to us downfield? And who can match up with him without weakening our overall defense? You're exactly right. It's a tough task to match up to him. You know, the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. What that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
20, green, 90.
On second down, here's Mahomes. It's Kelsey on the ground. The Chiefs have got the passing game rolling a bit. And another first down.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
Clock running, under 4 to play now as they come up on 1st and 10.
Here we go. 3-39. 3-39.
Blair takes the give from Mahomes.
Can not only spell your starter,
we got three down,
but can
three
come
down.
In and
hey,
keep
fellas,
drives
we got three.
Going.
Let's go.
Blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
So into Pat's territory now. Here's 1st and 10 at the 48-yard line.
Here we go now. Blue 45.
They're going to get this into enemy territory, but not by much as he's down at 48.
Thank you.
46. Back-to-back one-yard runs here, so that leaves him with a third down and 8. Success.
I do, and I know that without points, it's hard to say that a drive truly was a success. But think of it this way: changing field position, maybe giving your defense a little bit of credit.
Let's go.
Second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. With a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Four yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and 6.
Hey, 20! By 20!
In the end zone, and now third down.
Well, one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them, they've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard.
By 20!
New England on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is third and goal.
Wait, 20!
Again, it's Brady. Gretzky now out to kick it away. This will be fielded at the 8. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. And the Chiefs now getting set to go. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
Final play of the first half, barring a penalty, as they come up on first and 10.
90. Green 90.
Final shot before the half from the Hounds. So we've reached halftime here at Gillette Stadium with the Patriots on top. As we get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports halftime report. Coach, this will be taken in at the 1. That'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Here comes the Chiefs offensive unit as they'll have it to begin quarter number 3. They're close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half 2, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess that in the locker room, they talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, they're right there. What just not playing as well as we need to.
Green, 90.
And we still have a chance to win this game.
Let's give the kickers from week 5 some love. We had 4 game-winning kicks. Greg Joseph of the Browns, they beat the Ravens. Stephen Hauschka, the Bills over the Titans. Fairbairn at OT against the Cowboys. And the best of the best, the game that you did, Charles. Graham Gano, how about that 63-yarder for the win?
Yeah, and it might have been good up to 70.
Green 90. Green 90.
Fairbairn in overtime against the Cowboys. You don't want to do a first name. You don't want to say Kaimi. There you go. Mason Crosby, our green back. No one could have been the worst day. Had to have been the worst day of his 20 career. His 4 field goals and an extra point for making a meaningless field goal at the end of the ball game. That's something Green Bay's going to have to make sure they get corrected. I count on Mason Crosby to get that done. But last but not least, real quick.
Yeah, Greg Joseph. That was a Phil Negro knuckleball. Yeah, it should have counted. And the Browns, I feel like they deserve that after some of the tough luck they've had.
Good point.
Such a good job of frustrating these receivers tonight. Another example right there on the deep ball.
Sometimes when the sun goes down and it's just the bright lights in the stadium, there's an extra spring in their step, doesn't it? And that's what we're seeing from the defenders. Doesn't matter if it's man or zone. Deep ball, short ball, that was a deep one there. They're making plays on the football, contesting everything.
So a change of possession here on the punt. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. So here are the Patriots now. They get ready for their first possession of half number 2. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire.
20.
But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away. Defense, we got the deep. To the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see if the offense gets done.
Strong left. Wait, 20. Wait, 80. We got 4. Mike, we got.
They'll run it now. Out of the gun. Just a couple on the ground there, and that's going to bring up 3rd and about 6. The completion on 1st didn't get much, and now the run on 2nd doesn't get a whole lot either.
Well, if you're a good play caller, you've already looked ahead and anticipated this type of situation. Already down in his play sheet, trying to dial up a big 3rd down play.
Team. set, and it's first and 10.
Wait, 20! Who 20?
Going on first down is
pressure up front, nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
Wait, 20! Wait, 20!
This is a man out of the goal. Let's have this one up close to about the 45.
Hey.
They only get a yard back there. They'll be left with a third down and long.
Well, we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
New England on third down. They've been very good, 5 for 7 thus far. This will be a tough third and 18. Working from the gun, it's Brady. He's going to walk through a deep left side here. This is caught, and he just falls short down at the 1 yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Make sure that I don't take Tom Brady's greatness for granted. Let me make it routine. How about that throw right there? That was not a great completion.
And you know one area where he honed his throwing? He was a catcher in high school. He was actually drafted by the Expos in 1995 in the 18th round.
Wow, that would have been something to see him behind the dish. Run down a few guys trying to steal second. That would have been fun to watch.
He'll get it up the middle. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
Michelle on an island by himself in the backfield, second and goal.
Wait, 20! Wait, 20!
Now flags come in. Look like one of the Patriots might have moved. They try again on second and goal.
Go down.
Michelle going to try again. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Call it no gain that time, and now it's third and goal. So stuff for no gain on second down brings up a pretty interesting third from this distance.
I'm throwing the ball, and I'm not even thinking about play pass. I'm going to let him know right away I'm throwing it. I'm probably giving my quarterback some room, sprint him out to one side or the other, and give him an opportunity. If it breaks down, he can take off and run for it.
Brady now on third and goal. That's a decision there, no one open. He just throws it away. And that keeps the field goal on the table as it's fourth down.
Well, it's been a tough go for him. These guys have been driving down the field, but defensively, once they got their backs to the goal line, turned up the pressure. That's going to lead to a fourth down. Well played.
So now on fourth down, on comes Steven Goskowski to try and get the patch three. This from 25 yards out. And Goskowski's kick is good. And the lead moves to 10-0. So put another three on the board. All things considered, a good opening drive to begin the third quarter.
And as a defense, the way that this game is going, you're excited to see those points go on the board. Gives them a little bit of leeway to play with when they're out on the field, but they're real excited to see their offense score. Now they get to go out there and do their part.
Goskowski now converted for three. Now he'll kick this one away. This one fielded at the five. Take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not on the team anymore. I just cut it. All right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points.
Here we go. No 3-39.
Does that guy get on the field? 3-39.
Single point to its name. They're not totally out of this game yet. A touchdown here, they could be in business.
And how about that last play? Now they've got momentum going. So, you know, I'm a big advocate. Get back on the line of scrimmage. Throw another play.
Blue 45. Blue 45.
First and 10. Here's Mahomes. And this guy's a second shot midfield at the 50-yard line. He was looking for his tight end, Kelsey.
We always talk about possessions being at a premium in these games, and now in this situation, you have to claw your way back in. You're taking charge.
20! Out! Go!
They'll run it down. Out of the gun. And over the push is right forward.
Go, run!
Chris Jones on the stop. Offensively with the lead. You want to keep the clock going, but you also want to still kind of be in attack mode too, right? So how do you do that and not come back on your heels?
Yeah, think about all the practices we've watched where they have that tempo period to go over things just like this, where they describe the scenario, tell you what they're looking for, and make sure that they're still attacking, yet at the same time, they're going so fast as to leave too much time. Two extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
New England on third down. 6 conversions and 9 tries. They've done a great job of picking these up. This will be 3rd and 6.
20. By 20.
That was play fake. Brady. So on 4th down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. So this will be spotted on the midfield logo. It's a 58-yard attempt. And he missed it. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is.
Everything looked good. Good snap, good hold. Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go where you want it. And this one winds up no good.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up 1st and 10, just shy of midfield at the 48.
Here we go! Green 90! Green 90!
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. He's actually going to get there. Down he goes. Lawrence Guy able to get in there and drop him behind the line.
I know there'd be a little bit of criticism there because it went right back to the air.
Thankfully, the O-line failed to hold up to try to keep that momentum going.
Ready, green, three.
From the gun, it's Mahomes. And now he got tipped, kind of threw everything off, and brings up third.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
Here we go. Green 90. Green 90.
The pressure drops off as they look to throw. That's out to Hill. Right side complete. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there. Give him 13 yards there and a Kansas City first down. But correct me if I'm wrong, you know, you're down two scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full two-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call two plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
Ready! Green 39! Green 39!
Mahomes now on first down. To the right side, it's Kelsey. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there.
Here we go. Blue 45. Blue 45.
Maybe anticipating a blitz, and they jumped.
Yeah, and if we saw it, you know that they saw it. The bad guys might have been coming on that play. Had to pick them up, and they jumped.
And this will probably be the final play before the two-minute warning. Start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long.
Three down, three down.
Here we go now. Blue 45.
Down the Mahomes. His throw incomplete.
Didn't have a receiver open down. Good as a turnout. Couldn't even find his outlet, man, because the coverage was way too tight. Unable to find anyone.
The Chiefs on third down. They've had good success, 5 for 8 to this point. This will be third and forever.
Hey, Green!
Working from the gun, Mahomes. And he can't come up with a pick. Nearly his second of the game. Instead, fourth down. I guess they're in a situation now, fourth quarter, where they're forced to take some chances, but I don't know that that was the type of a chance you want to take.
And that one could very easily have been intercepted. If it does get picked off, that could possibly seal this one.
And Butker able to put this one through. And they get themselves on the board here. It's 10-3. So you knew one way or another that they needed the two scores. They get the easy one out of the way. Now they'll get the ball back, hopefully.
Yeah, and the question is, how do you accomplish that? Do you onside kick it? Or since you have all three timeouts, do you kick it deep? To me, I'm playing field position. With all three timeouts, I kick it deep and try and pin them back there.
So a minute and change to go, and this is going to be an onside kick. A tough one there. They certainly wanted that one. They needed it, but they didn't absolutely have to get it. They still do have three timeouts.
You're exactly right. They had to attempt it, but even though they didn't get it, as you noted, with three timeouts, if they can get these stops on defense, all hope is not lost.
By 20!
Now a first down carry, it's Michelle, and he'll take this one down to about the 4.
Yeah, baby.
Now here's a defensive timeout called by the Chiefs. As they get the stoppage with just over a minute to go in the game, the Patriot offense now set to come back out onto the field. And they've got to be a little bit frustrated about that last drive, missed field goal.
Always hurts a team because, you know, you put something out there, you've given yourself a chance, you're in range, and the ball doesn't go through the post. But it's not something to panic about, I don't believe. Just keep playing and keep going.
I have to imagine this will be on the ground as well as they come up 2nd and 7.
20! By 20!
Again, it's Michelle. Oh, now he bears him over. And he's going to get down to the 33-yard line here. Chiefs are going to signal for and be granted another timeout as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. So they'll come up 1st and 10 now from the 33.
By 20!
The Patriots in the victory formation as they'll take the knee. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. As they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. In the victory formation as they'll take the knee. And defensively, a dime look here. 6 DBs on 3rd and 12.
No surprise at all.
By 20!
Take a knee here, and that should just about do it. Charles, the old saying, the old cliche, if you will, points at a premium. That certainly applied here, didn't it?
And that almost felt like opened up a time capsule, didn't it? Old school football, low scoring, close game. What a way to finish it.
So that'll do it. For my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry, I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. The Patriots, winners here at home, as we say so long from Foxborough.